In physics, Newton's famous law of universal gravitation states that two bodies in space will pull each other with a force that is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the distance between them. There is an analog model to this in economics that helps us understand patterns of international trade. In its simplest form, this gravity model suggests that trade flows between countries increases with their market sizes and reduces as distance between them grows. Beyond the intuitive appeal, the gravity model also delivers a good fit to the patterns that we observe on data regarding trade flows. It can help us understand not only aggregate trade between countries, but also trade flows at the sectoral level. Subsequent research has also expanded this gravity model, for instance, showing that bilateral trade between countries is higher when they share a border, speak a common language, have similar cultural and legal institutions, are joint members of a customs union or the World Trade Organization. In recent years, economists have greatly deepened the theoretical foundations of this framework, such that the gravity model of trade is now the benchmark method which is used to evaluate the impact of various policies on trade flows between countries, such as the implementation of free trade agreements, the imposition of sanctions, and tariff wars.